Jeez, sorry.
Oh. So. Okay. As you guys probably know, and as it's probably the same in most of European countries, we're shut down everywhere, so getting all the food we want is kind of hard. Same happened for me. So I wanted to make an Austrian cooking stream today, and I actually wanted to make authentic Wiener Schnitzel. Now problem, and I think you're all gonna understand. We cannot make authentic Wiener Schnitzel today. If you don't know what Wiener Schnitzel is, it is basically a fried piece of meat, breaded and fried piece of meat, Heitel. The original Wiener Schnitzel is made out of baby cow. I forgot the word. What is it? Is it calf? I think is the word in English, right? So usually you would use calf for it. Sadly, we do not have any meat available right now in any local grocery store. So we're gonna make it out of chicken today. I was luckily able, not yesterday when I was out for groceries, but on Wednesday I was able to get two chicken breasts. They're still good till tomorrow, so we're gonna make schnitzel out of chicken breast. Again, there are a lot of people that don't really like to eat beef or baby beef, calf, or however you call it. Is calf the right word? So, we are making our schnitzel today out of chicken. And to be honest, I eat my schnitzel when I make it myself at home 90% of the time out of schnitzel, because I just personally prefer to eat chicken meat over other meats. It's just my own taste, so yeah. We are also, since schnitzel and potatoes and palatschinken, which is going to be the dessert, which I'm going to explain as well, is not going to take the usual 3 or 4 hours to prepare, we going to make a starter today, which is kind of the dessert and the starter at once. Now you're going to ask yourself, like, dessert and starter at the same time? What the fuck? So we're making 3 courses today. We're making a standard Fridatensuppe, if you don't know what that is. If I would roughly translate it, it is basically thinly sliced pancakes in beef stock. So it's a soup with pancakes. It's a typical Austrian thing. I don't know if other countries know that. It sounds probably a little bit weird if you haven't had it yet. Main course is gonna be schnitzel. In our case, it's gonna be chicken schnitzel with parsley potatoes. On the side, we're gonna have some jam. I forgot what the jam is called in English. We call it Preiselbeeren. It's kind, you would probably say cranberry jam, but it's not really cranberries. It's something different than cranberries, but it looks similar. And as a dessert, we're gonna have Palatschinken, which is also really, really typical for Austrian food. You will probably, if I explain to you what a Palatschinken is, it is basically a very, very skinny, thin pancake, or maybe some would compare it to like a crepe. So it's basically a thin crepe that we either fill with jam, marmalade, Nutella, something like that. You can basically fill it with whatever you want. Yeah, Eton, for us, everything is closed. Restaurants are only allowed to be open till 3 p.m. I think there's like, the state is just everywhere in the world right now, or at least in Europe, everything just closes down. So, I already made I made beef soup actually yesterday already, prepared it. You can, for that soup, you can obviously like whatever you want. You can cook in the beef bones. You can make a veggie soup if you prefer that. You can make it with chicken soup, whatever. You can cook all the soup yourself. You can just use the cubes if you want. You can basically do as you please. I personally prefer it the normal way, making it with beef stock. A beef soup where I'm gonna put in my pancakes, and yeah, we're gonna start making our mixture for the pancakes, or Palatschinken, what they're called in Austria. We're gonna have to let the dough sit a little bit, and then we're gonna make our Palatschinken, which is basically the dessert and the starter at the same time. Once we have that one done, we're gonna go for our potatoes. We could actually do the potatoes before. I feel like today is gonna be pretty fast. But it's fine. If it's not gonna take too long, we're gonna just game afterwards a little bit. We're not gonna make anything in a Thermomix today, but we're gonna use our Thermomix as a scale because I don't wanna go and get my normal scale out. We're gonna make our dough right now. No Thermomix amount. I know, right? Stream without Thermomix? How should that work? I'm just not sure how much I should make. Like, usually, I just checked. Usually, I make it with 150 grams of flour, 2 eggs, 250 ml of milk, butter, and salt. But I'm doing good, Creasy. How are you doing? So we, I'm just gonna start doing the mixture. So we're gonna use this as a scale. I'm gonna take our flour. I'm just wondering. I'm trying to remember how many pancakes I get out of this mixture. Because I feel like it's not too many. Where? Oopsie. Where is my flour? Let me just weigh the flour. As I said, 150 is what I usually use. I kind of want to take a little bit more. Because, again, we're going to use it for starter. For the starters and the dessert, right? So I'm going to use like 250 instead. Around that. I used 250 of flour instead of 150. So for 150, I would usually use like 2 eggs. It's depending on the size of the eggs. So for 250, I think I'm gonna go with 3 eggs and I'm gonna be fine. I'm gonna just check the consistency. When it comes to like the pancake dough or like palachinken or however you wanna call them, I'm like, it's like all about feeling for me. I don't know. I don't really have like a real recipe for it. It's more just the consistency needs to... You don't know, that's my egg. The consistency just needs to feel right, if that makes sense, right? Also, guys, have you seen? I have... No! Nope. Not... We do not touch. Have you seen my new kitchen towels? I got new tea towels. I guess I'm gonna go with like 350. No, you know? If I really wanted to, I think I could. But they say 3 to 4 days. Jesus, that's insane. You know, leave the milk. No, 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 no. We're not touching your milk. Otherwise, you're gonna have to leave, you know. So, I'm just breaking the yolks. And then I just mix everything together. So I'm just gonna mix this first, and then I'm gonna add some salt and a little bit of butter in the dough as well. So I didn't add the whole milk yet, because I wanna make sure the consistency is right. Like, basically... For the palachinken or like crepe or pancake dough or however you want to call it, you don't want it to be like super thick. You want to make, you want to have it still like, it needs to be liquidy enough to be able to like spread by itself in a pan for the kind of pancakes I want to do. It's depending. If you want to make thicker pancakes, you're going to have to make the dough thicker, obviously. Even though it's going to be a dessert, you always put salt in your pancake dough. And in the meanwhile, I'm just gonna put my dough in the fridge. You know, guys, you can all be happy that you don't have to eat my horrible food with the cat hair in it. There's no cat hair in the food itself, so don't you worry, guys. So basically, now we just made the dough for the pancakes. And we're just gonna let it rest for a few minutes. Doesn't really matter. Like, I think my mom always lets it for like half an hour, an hour. I usually sometimes, I mean, it's depending. It's depending how good you want your pancakes to be. If I'm in a rush, I just use it straight without letting it sit. What I'm gonna do next, I think we're gonna do the potatoes now. Yeah, let's do the potatoes. So weird. It's like, I think it's the first time that I cook without a complete recipe on stream. Usually, I always try like new things on a recipe on a stream because I feel like whenever I cook on stream, I want to do something like super fancy and like super, how do you say it, like with a lot of effort behind and something where I need to cook for a very long time. But yeah, this time, regarding like all the Corona things and almost everything being sold out in the store, I'm kind of limited to what I can make. That's why we're making simple food today. That's also why we're making a soup in the first. So So we're making parsley potatoes as a side for our schnitzel today. It's like the standard. Like, it's depending on which region in Austria you are. Some people like to eat potato salad with the schnitzel. Some people like the fries. Some people like rice. Some people have the potatoes. There are a lot of different versions. But I guess like the most standard side for a schnitzel, if you want it traditional, is parsley potatoes. Okay, I have to say one thing, which really offends me. Okay. That is a German thing. I don't even think you can get that in Austria. One thing that triggers me when it comes to schnitzel is those freaking horrible people that order schnitzel with a cream sauce and mushrooms. Jägerschnitzel or whatever it's called. Don't ever do that to a schnitzel. If you want to eat meat with a sauce, eat meat with a sauce. Don't eat. Why would you bread a schnitzel? Why would you make a crunchy schnitzel to drown a crunchy thing in a cream sauce? You know how much work it is to like actually bread schnitzel and stuff? And then you put fucking cream sauce on it? Just no. Just eat like the unfried schnitzel then. Just eat like normally cooked meat with the sauce. Also, I saw some of the comments, and we were talking about it last time already. Whenever I'm peeling something with my peeler, I know that I'm technically doing it wrong because I'm peeling towards me. You should always peel away from you. Sadly, I just learned it the wrong way, and now I can't relearn it, and everything would take just triple the time if I would do it the right way. So please don't do it the way I do. Stay safe, kids. Who of you is a big pancake maker? And also a question, does your mom or your granny or something, when they make pancakes, do they have a dedicated pancake pan? Is the question, because I do have a dedicated pancake pan. And there's also the rule that the first pancake you make is 90% of the time fucked up. Okay, let's do it. So what I always do when I make my pancakes, so this is the consistency, by the way, that you want to have. So not too thick, like it needs to be runny. Because basically what I do, I take a huge spoon and I like pour it into the pan. So like I take one of those, take a whole scoop, I put the scoop in a pan, and then I just move the pan around to like cover the whole thing. And then you just flip it. And you will also need a spatula. Spatula and a big spoony thing, and yeah, that should be the consistency of your pancake dough. Like, it needs to be runny for the kind of pancakes we're making. What do I want? Oh, butter for the pan. You can obviously make it with normal oil or whatever. I just like it with butter. You don't need too much. And rule number one, or not rule number one, but most of the time when you make... It's my butter. Most of the time when you make... You know, that's enough. Now you have to go. Too much cat everywhere. And yeah, the first pancake in the making is always going to look busted, okay? First pancake will always look fucked up. Will always look fucked up, so... So it needs to be very hot. But not too hot to burn it instantly. Like, pancakes are gonna go very fast. In the meanwhile, the pan is heating up. I have an induction stove, so it's gonna be pretty fast. I'm gonna take a plate, and I'm gonna take two sheets of kitchen paper, if you can get any in this rough time. I'm using this to like drain the oil from the pancakes later. I'm so excited for food today. And also, guys, we have an upgrade in the kitchen. You know how I always bought the parsley? Like the cut one? Now I got a basil plant. Parsley plant. I got a parsley plant now too, so we don't have to buy it every time. I hope it's gonna survive. I sometimes have problems with my herbs. So first of all, I'm gonna just get a glass where I can put the whisk in while I don't need it. I have my chat with me, so I can see you chat. The whisk away, And I'm gonna show you how I do it. So usually, I take one scoop per pancake, approximately, and then I put it in a pan, and you just move it around before it gets hard. The first one always is fucked. Whoops. Spilled a little bit at the edge. And that's the first one. First one always gonna look busted, but it's gonna be fine. I don't know if you could see it. I didn't even pay attention. And the pancakes don't really need long. So you're gonna see once the outside is solid, right? And basically, when you take your pancakes down, once you can like wiggle them around like this, that's when they're done. And once try it, please, to flip the pancake in the pan. Oof. I can try the first one because the first one is always fucked up. If you want, I can try the pancake flip. I'm pretty bad at it though. I don't think I ever tried it. Chad, you want me to try a pancake flip? Fuck. I made it! It flipped! Did you see it, guys? Professional chef right here. Thank you, Chad. I made it. Oh my god, yes. Can I get a clap? And the pancake is done. First pancake is done. I'm gonna show you in a second. That's the first one. That's the fucked up one. Keep that in mind. And now I'm gonna just scoop in the second one. So now we have the first one. That is how they should look like. Okay? If you're making Austrian pancakes, Palatschinken, Crepe, this is how they should look like, okay? Even the first one didn't turn out too bad. Kinda proud of myself. They're a little bit bigger than Crepe. They're Palatschinken. They're not pancakes. They're not Crepe. They're Palatschinken. So it's something like typical Austrian, right? I'm just gonna drain my potatoes from the water so they don't overcook. We don't need them to be like over the top soft or anything, because again, we're gonna make them in a pan later, like with some oil, some salt, and what is it called? Oil, salt, and some parsley. It's Hungarian pancakes, it's Austrian pancakes. It's we call them Palatschinken. I don't know, maybe they're called the same in Hungary. I know that like Austrian food has a lot of Hungarian influences, so it might be. How is that Austrian? You have the same here? Well, it's a typical Austrian dish. It's called Palatschinken. I mean, there are different kinds of pancakes all over the world. And you don't even know. I'm gonna use those pancakes for a soup. Do we have a pancake soup where you live? Oh, actually turned out great. Last pancake. We can put our potatoes in here. Palatschinken. We're gonna cut our pancakes now so we can use it for our soup. So I'm just gonna use basically the pancakes that didn't turn out that nice. So this one, for example, was the last one because we didn't have enough of the dough anymore. So basically how you cut them, you just roll it in. Yes, we're gonna cut the pancake, sorry. And then what we're doing is you cut it just in really thin stripes. Absolutely barbaric. What the fuck? It's just how it works. I'm sorry, guys. You wanted to have a typical Austrian cooking stream and you're getting it. It's like a really typical thing to eat in Austria. It's pancake soup. And for that, you need to cut the pancakes in thin strips. Yep, I'm just wondering, do we have another one that doesn't look that good? They're all looking decent, honestly. I don't know how much Nathan's gonna eat of this. I can love it. We eat them first? Yeah, basically that's how we do it too. So you make a bunch of pancakes, basically, right? And whatever is left over from the pancakes on the next day, you usually cut it in thin slices and you use it in soup. So it's like leftover food, like Alex said. I'm gonna have to clean that pan later. I'm just gonna let it cool down a little bit, because I don't wanna ruin it. In the meanwhile, we can do our schnitzel. So I'm cutting out some of the pieces of the chicken, right? Like all the... I don't even know how you call them in English. Like the tough parts of the chicken. So now for the breading, we gonna need egg, flour, some spices, and some breadcrumbs. So I'm gonna see, maybe one egg is enough. So we're gonna use one egg. We can mix a little bit of milk in. Wait. I'm whisking it! Then we need the breadcrumbs. We gonna put salt and pepper in our meat. Okay, so basically how it works, right? So now I'm gonna just turn it and season it on the other side as well. I just use salt and pepper. Like if you like, that's just like the basic way to make it, right? If you want to be fancy, you can put other spices on your chicken as well, but I mean, it's gonna be fried anyway, so. Okay, so now we're gonna bread our chicken. So what are you gonna do? You're gonna take your chicken and, or your meat, whatever you're gonna use. And you just put it in flour first. You make sure that it's completely coated in it. And then, I could actually put it in the right order, huh? That would be smart. And then when you had it in the flour, you put it into the egg. You can also, for example, do that with plastic bags, but again, works like this as well. And then you just put it in the breadcrumbs. Make sure that it's coated all evenly. And that is basically the first schnitzel in its breading. I mean, you can bread it however you want it. That's just like the original way of doing it, right? Here in Austria, at least. What do you do with your leftover breadcrumbs? With this, I throw them away. I wouldn't reuse it, because you have to think, you put raw meat in it, and there's so much bacteria that can stay in there. That's why I throw it away. Ground meat, yeah. So I try to always like use not too much that I throw away, obviously, but I wouldn't recommend reusing the breadcrumbs that you used, right, and fill it back in a box or something. I think that is not really... Yeah, there's raw egg in it, there's raw meat in it, or like traces of it. I don't know. A lot of bacteria, so I think you have to throw it away. There's no other way. I don't think you can... Like, there's one thing that I usually do with it. I'm not gonna do that on stream. Or I could do it on stream. So usually what I do is, with whatever I have left over of the flour, the breadcrumb, and the egg, I would just mix all three together and make like a thin patty out of it and fry that in the oil. So it's kind of just fried crust, if that makes sense. That's what I usually make. But it's not really like something super good, it's just me using my leftovers. I don't know if anybody else does that. We're gonna make a mixed salad. And all you're gonna need for it is, we're gonna need some potatoes. It's potatoes. What am I saying? Tomatoes. Mm-mm-mm. And an avocado. And some mozzarella. And then the secret. Secret is, you're gonna put an avocado in. Because avocado is freaking great. There we go. Oh, look at that avocado. Look how beautiful it is. So how I always handle my avocado, right? So I always slice it inside of the shell in the size I want it. Be careful that you don't cut yourself when you do it, by the way. I said and almost cut myself while doing that. So I just put it in this, and then I just take a spoon and just spoon it into my salad. And it's already cut. 200 IQ avocado slicing. I mean, probably everybody does it like that anyway, but... If you haven't had avocado in your salad, you're doing something wrong. Hi, Rock! So good. And then we spoon the other half in as well. Like, you don't necessarily have to use a whole avocado. I just really love avocado, so I use a whole one. I'm gonna drain my my mozzarella. If Nathan wouldn't be home, I would put onion in here as well, because I fucking love onion, but Nathan doesn't like onion, so we're not gonna put onion in there, otherwise he's not gonna eat it. No onion, yeah, I know. If you're smart, put onion in if you like it, it's so good. And then I'm gonna keep the rest of the mozzarella. I'm not gonna use a whole ball of mozzarella. Life hack, if you have mozzarella left over that you're not gonna use straight, basically the water the mozzarella comes in is not any special water, it's just water. So you can just put the rest of your mozzarella in a cup and just cover it in water so it doesn't get dry, and you just put it in the fridge like this. Life hack! And then we're just adding pepper. Stays moist like you in the stream. How you doing, Fudge? Then we add salt. I'm almost out of salt. Jesus. Need to refill my salt. How are you doing, Fudgy? Need to refill my salt. Let me refill my salt quick. Pink Himalayan salt is the best salt. Where is it? Where's my salt at? Wait, didn't I have more salt? Please don't tell me I ran out of salt. No! No, I have it. I have it. I have it. Oof. Got scared that I have no salt anymore. Imagine. Guys, I would be sure that you could help me out with some salt. Pink Himalayan salt. My favorite. I burn through so much salt. I'm not gonna lie to you. You can also put some garlic powder in or something. What I usually use, I have this herb mix for salad. Just put a little bit of that. And then I just let it sit like this. Till shortly before I start eating. So I'm going to put that in the fridge for now. Because if you put like the oil and the vinegar in now, everything is going to just get mushy. Haha, I said pussy in German. And then it's all soggy and ugh. Till you eat it. So we're going to need two pans. One for the schnitzel, one for the potatoes. I'm going to put my potatoes in the warm oil. I'm not waiting till the oil is super hot. And then I just put a bunch of salt on my potatoes, because you already know I like it salty, right? Our soup is cooking. Now we're just gonna cut some of the parsley. I got some. I'm gonna actually take it with me so I can talk with you in the meanwhile. Here I was just cutting the stuff from the what is it called? From the salad onion. So pancake soup, yes. Oh, and another sub. Thank you, Shrieking. No, it's not dill, it's what is it called? Not spring onion. Schnittlauch in German is what it's called. It's too warm. Ooh yeah, the potatoes are getting there. Now I can start doing our schnitzel. Like usually when the potatoes are like halfway through, I'm gonna show you the soup now. This is what the soup looks like. You wanna have that? I have two big ones. It's just looking at me. Who is gonna eat all this food? This is the schnitzel. Hmm? What did you say? You want a big one? Alone? So, now I'm just finishing off my salad with some oil. And some dark balsamic vinegar. Oh yeah, and I have a lemon, by the way, for the schnitzel. Oh, you want some salad? You like the soup? It's good, right? Nathan, Nathan approves the pancake soup, by the way. He's using a DreamHack jacket. Yes, he is. My hair looks nice. Thank you. It's Fridatensuppe. I think you called it Fledlersuppe, yes. Pancake soup. Nom, nom, nom. That is MK, yes. Correct. Can confirm. I'm gonna put my schnitzel on my plate. I'm gonna show you once I prepared it the way I want it, okay? The way we would serve it in Austria, right? We eat it with Preiselbeermarmelade. It's, what? How would you call it in English? Some kind of jam. Like, it's not... It's the same jam that the Swedes eat with their köttbullar. Köttbullar, sorry. Jesus! It looks so good! Damn, son! Let me get a chair, and then we can start to eat, guys. The soup alone, already so yummy. Now we're gonna have some schnitzel. Okay, and now comes the important part, right? You take the lemon, you have a piece of lemon, and you squeeze the lemon over the schnitzel. Ah! Oh, nice. And then you have the salad with it. Fuck yeah. Posted a video of the food on Twitter and Instagram, by the way. We don't know how we now melange. If you wanna be fully Austrian. Danach gibt's eine Palatschinken. The sound of eating is the ultimate trigger. Are you getting triggered by eating sounds? I'm sorry. Okay, now we're gonna have our dessert. Pancakes. They're pretty thin, they're Austrian pancakes. They're called Palatschinken. So I'm gonna have one or two of them. We usually eat them filled with either strawberry jam or apricot jam. Also, you can eat them with like Nutella or something like that, but I'm gonna stay true to being Austrian. I'm gonna take one with strawberry jam and one with apricot jam. So we just spread it and some whipped cream. I don't know, I just eat it like really plain. Really. I'm really boring when it comes to pancakes. Apricot jam! I think there's like something similar like this also in Poland, Hungary. And we just roll it up like this. Kind of feel like playing video games. We got a glass straw. No, I'm gonna play some video games. I'm gonna go downstairs and... I'm gonna play some video games. I'm not sure actually what I'm gonna play. Not sure what we're gonna play. We're gonna just chill downstairs, chat a little bit, and then we're gonna decide. Okay, guys. I'm gonna leave, but I'm gonna be right back, okay? Give me 2 to 5 minutes. Yeah, I'm a full-on lyric fangirl. Okay, guys, stream is gonna be off for maybe 5 minutes. I'm gonna be right back, okay? Don't leave me! Don't leave me, chat! I'm closing this laptop. Bye, guys!